Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Blackwell Epiphany. Alright, Madeline's taken over Rose's body, and I think I should probably do something about that. So, let's see what we can do.
Pretty solid, but it looks unlocked. I'm getting her back, one way or another.
I'm not sure what the other way would be. Not sure how much power I actually have over this situation.
Hey, Maddie.
Yes, Malone.
Now what?
I will simply live. I will grow old and I will die, like any other soul. And when that happens, perhaps I will move on as intended. It is a slim hope, but after centuries of existence, it is the best I have.
Why are you pacing around?
No reason. I am just enjoying the sensation. It has been a long time since I have felt snow on my face.
That's not your face.
True, I suppose, but no matter. I'm still enjoying it.
Enjoy it while you can. It's not gonna last.
You can't go any further, can you?
Whatever do you mean?
You're stuck. You're tied to Michael. Trying to escape it is like hitting a brick wall.
It is a temporary setback, nothing more.
What are you gonna do, lug Michael's body around in a wheelbarrow? I'd like to see that.
Don't be absurd. You know as well as I do, I am bound to his corporeal form for a few days. After that, I will be free.
Well, at least I have some time to fix the problem.
Ha! Some master plan. All this planning, all this death, and you can't even cross the street.
Only for a day or two. I can wait. I have infinite patience.
Yeah, but does your stomach? You're gonna get hungry.
Any problem has a solution.
What about going to the bathroom? Red drank a lot of coffee.
Perhaps burning Michael's body to ashes, or some kind of cleansing ritual.
Here's an idea. Take a powder. Just leave us the hell alone.
Will you let me think?
I can't wait for the cops to show up. A dead priest and you just around the corner? Bet you never expected to come back to life only to spend it in jail.
Will you be quiet? Honestly, why you haven't driven your host completely mad is beyond me.
Alright, at least she has to stay here for a while, that's good.
It looks like a schedule of services. Fortunately, nothing's going on right now. It's not like I can do much from in there.
Probably can't leave.
Unless she leaves with me, I'm stuck here.
Yeah. I guess I have to keep talking with her.
Hey, Maddie.
Yes, Malone.
You killed Lauren and Patricia.
I did not. I admit, their mind's rejection of me had unintentional consequences. But there was no malice intended.
Well, that's just Jake, as long as there was no malice. Maybe you didn't mean to kill Lauren and Patricia, but you did kill George Austin.
As a spirit, I hardly think so.
Bull, you're the only one with any motive. I don't know how, but it was you.
Poor Cooper. A weakened soul is such a sad thing. And his mind was so easily controlled. Why, in such a state, he could be told to do anything. Anything at all. And he would do it, with no memory of it. Well, perhaps some residual guilt remained. He has gotten quite agitated since it happened. Fortunately, that is no longer relevant.
I'm gonna fix this, one way or another.
You honestly believe that?
This might seem strange to you, but yeah. I've always known I was here for a reason. And maybe this is it. To fix what spooks like you screw up.
That is amusing.
Amusing?
Yes. You honestly don't know. No. No, of course you don't.
Of course I don't know what?
You think you are so special? You think you were what? Chosen? You were nothing important, Malone. You were merely the last.
The last what?
The last spirit we saved, before I was banished. I cannot continue the duty, so it was passed on to you.
What the hell do you mean, I was the last spirit you saved?
Honestly, Did you think you were different from any other lost soul? The confusion, the fear they all felt, that you felt. It is no wonder you have forgotten.
Doesn't matter. That was then. This is now. And right now, I plan on fixing this.
That's right, he was the last person that she saved. Before she was banished. I still have no idea what to do, though. I obviously can't
Unless
leave.
She leaves with weekend organ positively thrilling.
Yes, fascinating signs. I don't think they're gonna help me much.
It says Grace Church. I just can't.
I can blow on her.
What would that achieve?
I can give her my tie. Is that actually gonna do something?
Ugh.
What are you doing?
You know, Red and I have a bond. We gotta stick together. Where she goes, I go. You might be wearing Red's body, but you ain't her. There's a line in the snow, and you can't cross it. But Rosa Blackwell, she can cross it just fine.
You're hurting me.
Good.
Ah.
You idiot! Do you have any idea what you just did?
I just evicted you, sister.
No. No, I will not be trapped in that limbo again.
Tough. You made this mess, now clean it up.
Very well. Just remember, you brought this on yourself.
Red? Red, talk to me.
Joey?
You okay? Careful.
I feel...
You!
Great, like a bad penny.
Dispatch reported a woman ranting to herself in front of a church. I had a feeling it would be you.
Oh, God.
Here to explain the dead body around the corner?
Corey?
That's Officer Palmer. Now, explain.
No.
Miss Blackwell, I've been patient and cooperative so far.
No.
Stay where you are.
What the hell?
What are you doing?
Was it like this for them?
For who? Red?
I think it's happening.
Huh?
Oh.
Auntie, my grandmother, it's happening. It's like it's... No, it's too much.
Red, stop that. Come on, you're gonna hurt yourself. Jesus, cut it out. Not again, not you, not now. Help somebody. Anybody.
I did warn you. Gotta... No! No! Huh? Joey? Joey? God, I'm tired.
What the hell am I? It looks like the place where the spirits pass on. Sort of the same general look, but obviously it's not exactly at the portal.
I'm not sure what that is, but it really hurts my eyes. I don't think I could reach it.
Why, hello there.
The last time I saw Auntie alive, she was wasting away in a hospital bed, gray and gaunt. But now, she looks young. Younger than me, even. Hello, Auntie? Is that you?
Oh, hey. I saved you a seat.
Where are we?
You asked too many questions. You always did. Sit down, kiddo. We've got nothing but time. Cigarette?
No, thanks. Auntie?
Yeah, kiddo?
I don't know what I'm looking at here. but it's really pretty, whatever it is.
What happened to me? To us?
Don't know. Last I remember, my head hurt really bad. I tried to make it stop, but it just got worse. I might have thrown something?
You did. I was there.
Did I scream?
Yes.
I didn't hurt you, did I?
I hid in the closet.
Ah, good. Smart.
Yeah. We were possessed by this spirit called Madeline. She didn't succeed, but we ended up here, somehow.
Oh.
That's all you can say? Oh?
Does it really matter anymore?
I guess not. You look so young.
Well, I take care of myself.
No, that's not what I mean. When I last saw you, you were over 50, at least.
So I kept on living, huh?
You were alive, if that's what you mean.
Hospital bed. Like Mom.
Yeah.
Well, I guess it was my turn. And now, I guess it's yours.
I really, really hope it isn't.
I've missed you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Is this where you've been all this time?
Don't know. Don't much care. The view is nice, and I don't have Joey nagging me.
Auntie, is my grandmother here?
She was, but she faded away. I guess it will happen to me soon, and you. But in the meantime, let's enjoy the view.
Why didn't you tell me?
Tell you what?
About Joey? About my family? All of it?
You were 5 years old. You could barely understand how to tie your shoes. And I thought we had more time. But hey, you're here now, and we've got all the time in the world.
Auntie, you don't seem yourself.
You don't know me at all, kiddo. In this place, I feel more like myself than anywhere I've ever been.
Huh. Sure is a nice view, isn't it?
Yeah. Let's just enjoy it for a while.
Auntie?
Yeah, kiddo?
There's nothing left to talk about.
Huh.
Yeah.
It is very pretty. God, I really hope this isn't the fate of Rosa. But, given everything that's happened, it would make sense. They weren't able to handle it when Madeline took over their bodies. Rosa's stronger. But, is she strong enough? Well, I guess probably not, or I wouldn't be here, right?
Funny.
What?
I thought I might get up.
Why would you want to do that?
I don't know.
Something wrong?
No, I had an idea, but it doesn't seem important.
I know the feeling. Just kick back. Enjoy the light show.
I don't know. I think I kind of want to leave.
Something wrong?
No, I had an idea, but it doesn't seem important.
I know the feeling. Just kick back. Enjoy the light show.
It's pretty, but I don't really want to spend the rest of my life here.
It's like they're reading from a playbook. Constrained, drugged, placed under observation. In a week, they'll move you to another ward. Then they'll poke you full of needles and nod thoughtfully while taking notes. Then they'll move you to a long-term care floor. Keep you drugged, fed, washed. And then I'll watch you turn gray. I'll watch your skin weather and dry. And then, I'm sorry.
I'm so, so sorry. It's all my fault. I can't blame the universe, or death, or even you. This one's on me. Maybe I deserve it, but you certainly don't. There's gotta be a way to fix this. There has to be.
God, he's so powerless. He's bound to her. And yet there's almost nothing he can do. But obviously there's gotta be something. Not to mention, you've seen it happen before. Multiple times, right? At least once. I think multiple times.
She's still there, physically at least.
I don't know what else to do, or say, or anything.
The padded room might be overkill, but if the drugs ever wear off, better safe than sorry, I guess. It's the door to the cell, closed and locked, naturally. Blowing on her isn't gonna do any good.
I had to try it.
The padded room might be overkill, but if the drugs ever wear off, better safe than sorry. This place hasn't changed all that much since the last time I was here.
Home sweet home.
It's the door to another padded cell. Empty, for now anyway.
Oh.
Eh?
Hello?
Hello? Middle-aged guy, maybe early 50s. He must have died in that straitjacket.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey, are you okay, pal?
I should be okay.
You should be okay, but you're not?
I'm not like them. It should have worked.
What?
What exactly should have worked?
Everything. Nothing, maybe. Regret, maybe.
You regret something?
You know nothing of regret.
I might know a thing or two. So, who are you?
Everyone. No one. So many thoughts. So many.
I can see why I ended up here. Look, we're gonna be neighbors for a while, so maybe you could tone down the crazy?
No, I'm not that. Just the opposite.
The folks who run this place might disagree.
It's so hard to think.
Look, forget it. I got my own problems to deal with.
What a strange person.
I don't know what that is, but it can't be good.
Yeah, looks like there's a rip in the space-time continuum or something?
More technical crap that I don't know how to use. Guy manning the front desk. He wasn't around the last time I was stuck in this place. One of the few things that's changed around here. Jesus, what the hell is going on out there? Jeez. It's the elevator. The only way out of here I can see. There's a small keyhole above the button.
Let's blow on the receptionist.
He twitched a bit, but not much else. Looks like a duty roster for the orderlies. No point in reading it. I'll become very familiar with the staff here after a few years. Oh, this guy. Dr. Donald Quentin, or as I like to call him, Dr. Quack.
Age
that thing needs a date with a needle and thread.
Height,
or a
five
fireplace.
Feet, 4 inches. Weight, 118 pounds. Subject assaulted a police officer. Then herself. When restrained by a team of officers, she reacted so violently that two of them were hospitalized.
Damn.
Deemed a danger to herself and others, she was sedated and brought to this facility. Subject exhibits the same symptoms as other members of her family. Violent behavior, incognizant of surroundings, unresponsive to stimuli. 4 years ago, I advised the subject to submit herself to testing and regular visits. The subject declined. X-rays of the skull show no abnormalities. Scans of the brain show increased activity in the parietal and occipital lobes. They're exhibiting short but regular bursts of intense energy. These findings remain consistent with what we know of her family history. It's as if she is receiving sensory input from elsewhere, and it became too much for her brain to handle. There is so much we do not know. I will continue to observe and report any findings.
Her brain's overloaded.
Some kind of abstract thing, no idea what it could be. Another computer doing something incomprehensible. It's a tray of medical stuff. Bandages, scalpels, forceps. I don't want to think what they do with them here. That guy was Lauren Blackwell's doctor when she was here. Did nothing but plug her full of drugs. I guess it's Red's turn now. It's an x-ray of Red's noggin. I'm not just... They brought Red in on this thing. It's just a file cabinet, probably been here years. Just an old closet. Full of junk and old clothes.
Wonderful.
Huh, this letter is dated several years ago.
April 12th, 2010, to all staff from Donald Quinton, M.D. Be advised that no patient is to be placed in Unit 2 until further notice. As you're all aware, that unit was occupied by Mr. Benjiro Hattori until his death last week. The room has been deemed unsafe by hospital inspectors. So it happened years ago. Benjiro Hattori, he was the person who ran the Grace Group. Interesting. There's obviously something going on here. I'm not exactly sure what, though. Well, let's go talk with Benjiro. I knew it would be a while till I finally figured out who he was. Now I know. Well, I know his name. Still a lot more to learn about who he really is, though.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey, I did some research, kinda. You're Benjiro, aren't you?
Benjiro?
Yeah, Benjiro Hattori. You were the last guy to occupy this room, so I'm guessing you're him.
What do you know of me?
You ran those Grace Group meetings.
Yes, that was so long ago. How long has it been?
25 years.
25 years? Have I really spent 2 decades of my life in this place?
More than that, Benjiro.
More than that?
You died here. You're haunting the padded room where they locked you up.
Yes, I thought as much.
You thought as much? You're saying you know you're dead?
I suspected, but I couldn't be sure.
Why did you suspect?
You suspected? What gave you your first clue? Folks stop returning your calls?
No need to be flippant. My people spend so much time avoiding death that we refuse to believe it when it happens.
Your people?
Yes, I'm part of a society. Some would call us vampires, but not the kind from stories. We extend our own lives by consuming the positive energy from willing subjects. They die, but we live.
Okay.
We ran into one of your people last year. Guy named Gavin. He killed a bunch of people. He tried to kill us. He's dead now.
I see. You must understand, I am not like my colleagues. I never liked hurting people, but I didn't want to die either. So I made a point of studying the life energy we consumed. I created the Epiphany experiment.
The Epiphany experiment?
I wanted to improve the lives of those I fed upon, not destroy them. Instead of removing positive energy from a subject, I increased it. I enabled them to achieve their heart's hidden desire, to create a surplus of positive energy, and I skimmed off the top.
I see. So that's why all of them finally found their purpose when they went to the Grace Group. Just magically. Because it basically was magic. But it didn't turn out too well.
And this worked?
Yes, and no. It worked too well. My mind couldn't take the energy. I went a bit mad. Ended up committed here, and here I am.
Well, I hope you're satisfied. Your experiment ended up killing your subjects. Even worse, their souls.
Their souls?
You made them weak. Weak enough that they got, well, soul-napped by this spook named Madeline.
I see. I did not consider that eventuality, but it does explain much.
Eh?
Come with me. I must show you something.
What exactly do you have to show me?
Whatever that thing is.
That vortex. I witnessed its formation. I did not believe what I was seeing.
Why? What is it?
Energy is siphoning through the void at an alarming rate. Something is calling it, drawing it like a beacon. Something with enormous power.
Something, huh? And what is this something?
I cannot say, but don't you recognize the location? That vortex is over Grace Church.
Madeline.
Yes, if she has harnessed as much energy as you say, that is the only answer. But why would she do such a thing? What she is doing will destroy her soul, rip it into shreds.
She said she wanted to stop existing. I guess this was her backup plan. Good riddance.
You don't understand. This energy, it won't stop at just her. It will expand until it dissipates. It could destroy every soul, living or dead, within a 10-mile radius.
Oh.
Of course it will. Damn it, this is my fault. Again, I set her loose. It's not enough, is it? It's not enough to destroy 3 generations of women. It's not enough to destroy 6 spooks. No. You gotta fry your own soul into oblivion and take the whole damn city with you. So, what do we do? Where the hell are you going?
I am leaving. I must get myself out of range.
What are you gonna do, haunt Jersey?
If I must.
What about the rest of us?
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry? That's it?
That is all I can offer. I fear that everything I've done only makes matters worse.
Hey, get back here! Damn it!
Thanks, Benjiro. At least it was partially helpful.
Jesus, if that Benjiro guy is right, we gotta find a way to stop that thing.
Okay, well, I need to get Red to wake up. Well, I just called her Red instead of Rosa.
It's the door to Red's cell. It'll be her home for a while, until they move her to long term anyway.
I guess Joey's term for her is rubbing off on me. But I can't just talk to her. She's not... She doesn't respond to any outside stimulus at all.
Blowing on her isn't gonna... The padded... Better say... Red? It's me.
Or maybe?
Are you even in there? Are you somewhere else?
You're still breathing. You're still alive. I figure somehow, maybe, you can hear me. Maybe I'm wrong, but talking is all I'm good for these days, so what else can I do? You gotta wake up. Things are bad out there. Really, really bad. So bad that I'm not sure we can stop it. But we gotta try. We're the only ones who can. You understand? We. It's gotta be the both of us. Because let's face it, I'm nothing. Just a gust of wind. I don't know what to do. Just get up. Get up, and we'll fix this. Somehow, I promise. Please? Please?
She can hear.
Did you hear that?
Hmm? No.
I did.
I...
Just get up.
Are you hearing that?
Get up, and we'll fix this.
I don't hear anything.
I think...
Somehow, I promise.
I really think...
Please?
You okay?
I'm fine. I'm gonna look around.
Sure, kiddo. I'm not going anywhere.
Some bits of the rock have broken off and are beginning to float away. They're too far away.
Let's see if I can climb up there.
It's too slick to climb.
Hmm.
Looks like there's another path up there.
Alright, so how do I get up there? I don't have anything on me.
Some bits of the rock have...
Too far away, obviously. And it's too slick.
It's too slick to climb.
Is there something around here I can pick up? Give me some extra height.
Auntie?
Yeah, kiddo?
Or perhaps you can help me up.
Auntie, could you get up?
Why?
I thought maybe we could take a walk around this place. Maybe find a way out.
I'm fine right here.
Please, Auntie. I think you really need to get away from there.
I told you, I'm fine right here.
Auntie, there's this ledge. I can't reach it. I could really use your help getting up there.
What's the point?
There might be a way out. Something to get us out of here.
Why would I want to do that?
I'm dying out there. If I stay here too long, I'll die.
Is that all? Life and death are just the opposite sides of the same door. Doesn't matter which side you're on, it's all the same.
I'd like to keep living if I can, thank you.
I think Joey needs our help.
He doesn't deserve it.
Excuse me?
Joey's told me stories about how he saved your life. He saved mine too.
Only after putting us in danger in the first place.
You can't blame him for that.
Just watch me.
Joey was so wrong about you.
What do you mean?
He doesn't say much about his past, but get him talking about you and he won't shut up. You should be more like Lauren, Red. Your aunt wouldn't take that from nobody. He didn't mean to, but for years he made me feel like I couldn't measure up, that I was nothing, insignificant when compared to you. But he really didn't know you, did he? You don't actually care about anything.
How could I? Joey's voice in my ear, always pushing me, following me around like a lost puppy, in all those ghosts, night after night after night. I just got numb. Then my brother died. I decided I could do something good for once. Something real, something tangible. That something was raising you. So don't you dare throw that in my face.
I'm sorry, Auntie, but I can't believe that. If you really cared, you'd fight. You'd help me.
You never were this stubborn as a 5-year-old.
I grew up.
All right.
This is it. Can you give me a boost up there?
Sure, I guess. You've gotten bigger since I last saw you.
Here. Come on, I'm not leaving you here.
fine.
Even if she managed to get out, what exactly would happen? Because my body's still out there, hers is not.
Auntie, are you okay?
Nothing, it's just...
Auntie!
What?
We need to keep moving.
It hurts. Don't you feel it?
Yes, but I can't stay here, and neither can you.
Do you feel it?
Yeah. Let's keep moving.
Into the question mark.
That light, it's so beautiful. After I'd send a ghost off, I'd just sit there and stare, try to make sense out of it, wonder what was on the other side. I suppose now I can. I'm dead out there, aren't I? Back in New York.
Yes. I'm sorry.
I should have realized. I've had this conversation so many times. I remember now how it happened. Someone trying to take over my mind. It cracked my head open, let the universe pour through. It hurt.
I know. It happened to me.
A part of me escaped, hid out there in the void, anything to get away. You brought me back.
We brought each other back.
I just gave you a boost. You didn't really need me. But of course, you never really did you?
Auntie, I think...
Yeah, I know. It's time. I know how this works. Say hi to Joey for me, huh? And tell him... You know what? Don't tell him anything. It'll drive him crazy.
Holy Jesus! Red? Is that you?
Joey? Oh my god, my head.
You're back? You're really back?
I think so. Where am I? And what am I wearing?
Short version, you're in the loony bin. You wouldn't believe what's going on out there.
Madeline is pulling energy through the void. This will create a spiritual explosion that will destroy all souls within range.
Yeah? How'd you know that?
I think it's the universe pouring into my head.
Okay.
It is how both Lauren and Patricia met their end. Their minds could not take the pressure. Their souls hid in the void until they died. I found my way back.
Ow!
You're not gonna relapse, are you?
No, it's bad, but not as bad as before. I can control it, kind of.
Well, we'll deal with that later. Can you get out of that jacket?
No.
Okay, first things first, let's get you out of here. And Red?
Yeah?
Don't you dare scare me like that again.
Okay, I can actually do something now. Thank God. I mean, in terms of the story, not like the game was like a perpetual cutscene. I just mean, now I can actually... do something. Red's actually awake. I actually have some control over the situation now.
Ugh, come on, Rosa, move. Ugh, I can't reach it.
Can she stand up? No, I don't think she can.
Almost moved that time. Come on, you can do this.
Oh, maybe she can. Ugh,
I can't reach it.
Wait, can't reach what?
Okay, I'm mobile. Kind of.
Okay.
I can't reach it.
She can wriggle over the ground. I'm still not sure what she's trying to reach. Well, there's a flap. I'm guessing I'm going to have to give her an item. Oh. Whoa.
What the hell was that?
I guess the vortex is getting bigger. I believe there's a scalpel on the desk. Is he sleeping or is he dead?
He's unconscious.
Okay.
I can't do anything to help him. I can't do anything. Jesus, if that Benjiro guy is right, we gotta find a way to...
Yep. And there's the scalpel. Okay, so I guess the vortex is already starting to do stuff.
He's unconscious. It's a tray of medical stuff.
Alright. Here we go. Well, this is going to be quite the news story, isn't it? Nearly the entire town? Unconscious? Alright, I need to open up the flap. I don't think I can blow on the flap.
I'm not just...
Okay. So, I need to keep her moving.
What the hell is going on? This whole building is shaking!
This is starting. The effects of the void energy are taking root. The entire city has fallen unconscious. We are the only ones awake.
We're the only ones? Why?
We have both been to the void. We are immune to most of its effects. But we will not survive if and when the energy reaches critical mass.
How? Damn it!
Alright, this new ability of yours, scaring the crap out of me. Still, one crisis at a time. We need to get you out of here.
Yeah, it's a bit creepy. It's a bit creepy. You know, normally I was just saving individual souls, but now I'm actually saving an entire town. I'm gonna be quite the hero.
Come on. I can't...
Move. Move. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, wriggle across the ground. Uncomfortably and strangely. Like some sort of a weird worm. There we go. Now we're in business. The cutting open by constricting jacket thing business. Straight jacket, that's what it's called.
Lock tight. Great.
No, of course. It's gonna come in handy, of course.
I don't want to be anywhere near that thing again.
What if I just start cutting out the walls?
Aha! An old vent.
Aha!
Looks like it was part of an old ventilation system before this room was converted into a padded cell. No good. Looks like it was part of an old ventil...
Don't suppose I can cut the other walls at all? Anything?
Huh. There's an old pipe against this wall. Huh. Looks like the piping runs along that...
Oh, there we go. Pry it open, there we go.
I can walk just fine. I can walk...
Yeah, I can use it as a weapon, though. But I suppose I have a pipe and a scalpel, so those are pretty good weapons.
It's just an old... This closet looks like it seems...
Normally I like to examine everything, but I'm feeling like I should probably just leave because the whole city's about to explode.
I don't need a wheel.
So, let's just go.
He's unconscious, but he'll be fine, assuming we can stop Madeline before it's too late. I'd love to see what kind of files they have on me, but we need to get out of here.
Yeah, okay, time to go. Key's probably on the receptionist.
The only thing I can do to help him is to stop Madeline.
Or maybe not.
He's unconscious, but he'll...
This needs a key, right?
Nothing.
Yeah, it needs
There's
a key.
There's a small keyhole above the button.
Could shove the scalpel inside of it.
I don't need to...
Nope. maybe it's on the doctor.
He's unconscious. The only thing I can... We don't have the time. Just a...
Key.
A hospital. I don't have to.
Apparently that's not the key. Maybe it's on the doctor. That's my best guess. Let's roll with it.
The only thing I can do...
Okay. It's not on him.
I don't need... It's worn through in the button.
Not in there. So... dead.
I don't want to stick around here.
I'm obviously meant to leave very quickly, so I don't imagine there's a particularly complicated puzzle here. Perhaps this is a reversal of my first puzzle curse. The last puzzle, maybe.
Just an elevator. There's a small...
I mean, I could hit it.
Things might be bad, but I'm not going to start hitting random things with the pipes.
Okay, fair enough. What the bloody hell is the key? I can't believe it's not on the receptionist. That seems exactly like where it would be.
The only thing I... He's unconscious. It's happening. We don't have much time.
And that looks like the key right there, but I can't pick it up, so apparently it's not. Right, so I can't hit it. I can't use the scalpel on it. Could I just pry open the doors?
Things might be bad, but...
No. Whoops. I just clicked out of the game window. Yeah,
Come on, Joey.
I'm right.
I could break the window. That doesn't seem smart. Seems like we're pretty high up.
It's a duty rock. There's no
No time to mess around, exactly. I should have already been gone from here. Why am I stuck here? This is not good. It's not in the coat, it's not in the doctor, it's not in the receptionist. Is there a pixel I'm missing? Am I missing a pixel? Do I need to go on a pixel hunt? I will go on a pixel hunt. I will hunt down that pixel if I need to. It will happen. And then I'm gonna stuff that pixel and I'm gonna put it up on my wall. As a trophy pixel.
We don't have...
Yeah, I can't examine anything in depth because we're supposed to already have left. So...
There's a key hanging on the inside. And my clothes, thank God.
Oh!
You mind?
Right. You ready?
Let's go.
Okay. Oh, that's not good. Okay, let's go. Let's go right now. Still have no idea how I'm actually going to stop her, but I certainly can't do it unless I'm there at her, where she is. So, let's take things one step at a time. Step one, get to her. Step two, I don't know. Step three, save the world. Or at least this town. Or city. I guess it's a city, not a town. Pretty sure towns don't have skyscrapers. Which place? Well, she's at the Grace Church. Here? I don't know.
You okay?
30 blocks. Never ran. So fast.
She's up there.
She's gathering the energy within herself, trying to force her own spirit to weaken and break apart. Her spirit is strong, but her resolve is stronger.
How do we stop her?
I don't know.
Nothing like this has ever happened before. Not even the universe knows what to do.
Well, I guess we'll do what we always do, sweetheart. Improvise.
Sounds like a plan. A very, very rough plan that may result in failure. But it's a plan.
Jesus, he's still here?
Nobody can get near this building without being affected by the void energy. Nobody except us.
Ow! God damn it, that hurts.
Madeline!
You! How on earth did your mind survive? Your head must be absolutely splitting.
It's over, Madeline.
Indeed. I have wanted it to be over for a long, long time. Madeline, what?
Please stop this, like she's gonna stop it. I don't think I can appeal to her kinder side, because I don't think she has one. Not anymore. I think being left alone in the void for practically an eternity has ruined that part of her.
You destroyed my family. It was nothing personal. You don't understand, do you? We could have supported each other. We could have been normal. You took that from us, from me. And yet, here you are. Don't tell me you are worse off. You survived, thrived even.
Not for much longer if you keep this up.
As I said, this is nothing personal.
We're going to stop you, Madeline.
And what makes you think that?
We've stopped others before you, we can do it again.
Others before me? Like who?
Well, we certainly stopped the Countess.
The Countess. My aunt killed her. I finished her off.
You forget. She was my host once. Whatever happened to her, it was her own undoing. I am through with being at the service of hosts like her. Of anyone like her.
And this is how you're doing it?
There is no other way.
We stopped the Deacon.
That mad, incorrigible soul. A man so insane with fear that he created the devil out of thin air. There are so many spirits like him. Spirits so scared and so desperate that they will do anything to escape. Your Deacon would have welcomed the oblivion that I am bringing.
It just occurred to me, the fact that people are going unconscious means that she's already murdered people. Because, think about this, people in cars just instantly going unconscious. People in maybe planes if they are flying close overhead, maybe, depending on how far it's gone. There's a lot of situations where people going unconscious would just leave them dead. Somebody swimming, unconscious, now they're drowned. She's already murdered hundreds, maybe thousands of people, simply by having people go unconscious, I would think. Yeah.
I stopped Gavin. He got into my head and I forced him out.
Gavin? Yes. I sensed it when you killed him.
That was an accident.
Be that as it may, his soul was weak after he tried to feed on you. It didn't take long to overpower him. So, thank you for delivering him to me.
You've spent hundreds of years helping out souls like them. You're really gonna throw all that away?
You say that like they matter. Since humanity crawled out of the ocean, they began to deny death. Denied it so much that the post of bestower was created. In all that time, humanity has learned nothing. Helping their pathetic souls all this time has achieved nothing.
So you'll destroy them all?
It is a means to an end, nothing more.
God, I don't want to beg her.
Please, Madeline, you tried. You failed. Just stop before any more damage is done.
Failed? No. I admit my original plan did not proceed as I'd hoped. This is just a viable alternative.
This is not the only alternative. We will help you find another way.
Can you really? The universe is pouring into your head. Your head is splitting from the pressure of it. So tell me, with all of this newfound knowledge, can you give me even one alternative to achieve what I need?
Possess me again. Oh, God. That doesn't sound like a good option, but it might be the only one. But what then? After she possesses me, what? Just... I mean, I guess she could stay in my body.
Possess me again.
What?
I mean it. If it means all this stops, do it.
I have expended too much energy. Your mind would overpower me and reject me, like all the others. but the offer is appreciated.
I'm kind of relieved that's not actually a good option. Not a possible option.
The entire city is asleep. If we're going to do something, it has to be now. She's being pulled apart. We don't have a lot of time.
Hey, Maddie!
What?
You've got to stop this. You're going to fry every soul in this city.
I wish I could say that I feel remorse, but I am so old. I am so tired. I cannot muster the energy to even pretend to care any longer.
I said it before, Maddie, but you're insane.
I just want what every creature has. The ability to die. Can't you understand? But the universe has denied it to me. So I am turning to the only recourse available.
Why here? Why not just go to the middle of the ocean and zap yourself there? Or the desert? Or the moon? Anywhere but here.
I am bound to this area thanks to you. And the soul energy I absorbed will only last for a limited time. I have no choice.
Great.
You always have a choice.
I have sought another way for centuries. I am sure you have asked this same question of yourself, Malone. When will this end? Well, I have the answer. It doesn't. I am finished with being at the whims of an unknowable universe. I am taking my fate into my own hands. You would do the same in my position.
Get this through your thick head. This is where it ends.
Oh, you have no idea.
We're nothing alike, Maddie. Don't even pretend to think we are.
You think you're so noble, little ghost. Wait 2 or 3 centuries. 2 or 3 millennia. Then tell me you would not do the same just to end it all.
Can I actually grab her? We're about to find out.
Eh?
It has started. My spiritual form is becoming intangible, even to you. It won't be long now.
Great. Okay then. I'm not sure beating a ghost over the head with a pipe would be effective.
Joey?
Yeah?
Let's have a chat.
We got here just in time. Look at her. She's tearing herself apart.
Normally I'd say good riddance, but I guess we gotta stop her.
She's going to be ripped apart any minute, and she'll take us all with her.
No, we're gonna stop her. We have to stop her.
Let's try the pipe solution.
That won't help.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Might be a little bit of a problem.
It won't work. I can't touch her.
Yeah, okay, so if we can't touch her, then do we have to do something with the body? Since she's bound to it?
I'm sorry, Michael. He's got a piece of chalk in his pocket. It looks like he used it to draw the circle.
Hmm.
He wasn't carrying anything else. I'm sorry. A piece of chalk?
Okay. So I could use that to... something?
Not now.
Not sure what the plan on the piece of chalk is.
That won't help.
Hey!
What?
Madeline, what?
Okay, chalk achieved. Got a scalpel and some chalk. I can cut the... No, I can't cut it. I wanted to make fine artwork out of this stick of chalk. I'm disappointed. Yeah, I have no idea what to do with it. Can I just leave? I mean, there's still the police station.
The police can't help with this.
And that's what I figured.
I can't go home. Not yet.
Okay.
I'm not going to run.
I could put down some chalk. Okay. But why? I don't understand why I just did that.
it's the circle of protection that Madeline created for Michael. Madeline activated it by using a part of her essence.
Okay, so I need a part of her essence. And I don't currently have that. How would I get that? I can't even touch her.
I'm sorry, Mom. It's the circle of protection. Madeline activated.
What exactly am I going to be protecting, though? I don't understand.
That won't help. Madeline, what?
Madeline said she used a bit of her essence to activate that circle, that this totem would zap spooks into it.
Okay, so maybe I could use that to... But I can't even touch her, so she wouldn't touch it. Right?
Are you trying to use my own essence on me?
Yeah?
Such an action speaks of desperation. It will not be long before you will not need to worry about such things.
Yeah, that seemed a bit pointless. Blue on you.
I don't re-
Take my die.
It won't work.
Yeah, I can't freaking touch her. Where could I get her essence, and why would I want a circle of protection? I couldn't teleport her into it anyway. It's her own totem.
She's being ripped up.
I feel like in a lot of Wajedi games, I found the final sort of boss confrontation, if you will, to be very awkward. And just like, what am I supposed to do? And I just end up clicking on everything with everything, and that's exactly how this has gone, unfortunately. Thankfully, there's not too many places to go or too many things to click on. I've got a key for a thing that doesn't matter. I've got a pipe. Unfortunately, she can't be touched. Got a scalpel. Again, she can't be touched. Got a piece of chalk. Already did the circle. Don't know why I'm doing the circle for some reason. And yeah. Okay.
I'm sorry, Michael. I'm not wiping it away. Joey.
Yeah?
Help me out here.
Madeline is incorporeal, more so than usual.
So, punching her senseless is out. What else you got?
A piece of chalk?
Glad to see the universe pouring into your head hasn't dulled your wits any.
Funny, but also not helpful at all. I still have nothing more than a piece of chalk. Right, I've got a chalk outline in the street. Whoop-de-doo. That's step one in saving the world. Slash city. More? I guess I just drew it again. I could just keep drawing it. Wait, can I just draw whatever I want? Or... No, it only goes in the one spot.
I don't need...
No, I didn't think so.
Things might be bad. This key...
There's a sign.
No need to pay attention to that. There aren't...
Hit it. Hit it with a pipe.
Things might...
No. She's more incorporeal than usual. Right.
I don't think he would...
Can I make a thing of essence if I had, like, his... stuff on it?
Madeline said she used a bit of her essence to activate that circle
totem
would zap spooks into it. Well, here goes.
Okay, there we go. His own essence, any spirit's essence, okay. Now... I have my own totem. So... I'm assuming she's gonna be stuck in here if she goes in there, so let's go do it. There we go. Got it. This should work a little bit better than the last one. Come on, there we go. Hi!
What is this? Oh, how cute.
Oh, okay.
So, you learned a new trick. I'm impressed.
Well, that didn't work too well, did it? Hey, Rosa. What do we do?
Yeah.
So sending Maddie on a joyride achieved squat.
Maybe. We need to send her somewhere so far away that she can't get back.
Okay.
So sending...
Maybe.
Right, if she can't get out of range of Father Michael and we teleport her somewhere out of range, what happens? Does she die? Does she get destroyed? I guess we're about to find out. So, where? Police station?
The police can't... I can't go...
Wait, what?
I can't...
I don't get it. If I can't leave, then...
Give me just a second. I'm gonna add that to my list.
Oh, okay. I had to look up a walkthrough. Yeah, you just use the tie on Rosa, that's so that you go to the place.
Look, whatever she's doing, it's happening on the other side. Maybe we should take a look?
Yeah, I mean, I suppose that makes sense. I was thinking if I could go someplace like this, if I could return to this world... Again, that'd obviously be a place very far away to teleport her to. However, I didn't make the connection between the tie, because every time we've used the tie, it's been with Rosa and the ghost. I never really considered whether you could even use it just with Rosa. I don't know if they've ever established that. So, a bit strange. Anyway. This should be pretty far away, huh? Does that mean we're gonna leave her back in the void? Oh, she's not gonna like that, is she? And I don't care. Actually, wait, I probably need to use it on... Yeah, I used it on the wrong one. Now we're in business. Okay, here we go. Goodbye.
Forever. You'll never get out.
This place. Well, no matter.
Hey.
You.
You remember me. I guess I should be flattered.
Open the portal. Let me through.
You've got to be kidding.
The energy is almost at critical mass. It is going to detonate whether I am there or not.
Oh,
that's all you can say. Millions of souls will be destroyed. I need to be one of them.
We all need something. I thought I needed to move on, but I really want to see how this ends.
It will never end. I will never end. That was the whole purpose.
It was never about you. Not me, or my niece, or any of us. You see, I get it now. Why things have to be the way they are. I don't like it, but I get it.
What are you talking about? Shh.
I'm on a smoke break.
It didn't stop.
No.
It's not going to stop.
No.
This is it, isn't it?
No. No, it isn't.
So many dead, Joey, so many.
I know.
It's never enough.
I know, but we do the best we can. We always have.
Yes, we always have.
What the... Are those spooks?
Yes. Everyone who is lost. Everyone who is waiting. Waiting for someone like us. No more. They don't have to wait anymore.
You're saving spooks?
It's what we do.
But how?
That vortex. It was creating a massive spiritual energy. I am reversing it. Making it pull in spiritual energy instead of pushing it out.
You can do that?
I can now.
You see, it's not about you or me. It's about everyone.
Go on, Joey.
Go on?
It's time. Move on. You can do it now. Whatever stopped you from moving on before, I'm stronger.
It's not working.
What?
I said it's not working. It won't let me go.
Try it now.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, but I'm still stuck. Not even the power of the universe inside your head can help me move on. It's gone.
I'm sorry, Joey.
Forget it. So, you think everyone down there is back to normal?
Yes. Everyone will wake up. They won't even know they were asleep. It will be like it never happened.
Yeah. We should get out of here. So, how many spooks did you manage to save, anyway?
All of them.
All of them?
Yes.
So, are we talking all the spooks here in the city, or...?
No. All ghosts. Everywhere.
Except for me.
Except for you.
That's...
I know.
Look, don't sweat it. I mean, people are still gonna die, right? There'll be more ghosts.
Eventually.
Right, so when that happens, it'll be business as usual.
I guess.
But in the meantime, we're free.
Free?
Yeah. How about a movie or something?
God, I haven't seen a movie in forever.
You and me both. Think of all the things we can do now.
Maybe I'll sleep in.
Or maybe a vacation?
Yeah. Somewhere sunny.
Huh?
I'm sorry, Joey. I thought you'd be gone. I really hoped you'd be gone. I didn't want you to see this.
Red?
It hurts, Joey. It's everything. It's pouring into my head. It's not a metaphor, and it's not stopping. I can't hold it.
You gotta try.
No. It's like trying to swallow the ocean. Sooner or later, you're going to drown.
No, not after what you just did. Not after everything we've done. You can't just...
What? Die? I don't think I have a choice.
No, this isn't fair. This isn't right. You just saved the whole damn city. You saved me.
I knew the cost. I paid it. It was worth it, wasn't it?
Sure. Of course it was.
I see them. My parents, Joey, I see them.
No, stay away from them. It's not time yet.
Joey, please.
Okay, but before you go, I'll make you one promise. No matter how long I'm around, no matter how many hosts I see die, I'm not gonna turn into Madeline. Ever. Not if I'm a spook for a million years. I'll be a good spirit guide. Do what needs to be done. Forever if need be.
No, Joey. You won't.
What the... What did you... How? Red? Sweetheart? Rosa? Why the hell did you do this? Here. Go on, take it. Take it. Just... I don't see him anymore. I've tried, you know. I've looked. There was this pileup on the West Side Highway last week, and now people say they hear crying. So I went over there. I didn't hear or see anything. I'm normal. Listen to me, talking to myself on the street. I call myself normal. Yeah, I know. Ironic, huh? Or at least I think that's irony. You could tell me if you were here. I'm forgetting things. About being, you know, I can't even say it. It's almost as if, now that I'm alive, I can't think about being dead. Guess that's hardwired into everybody. Turns out I'm just like everyone else in the end. But I get it now. I like being alive. Is that so wrong? Is that what I'm supposed to get from all this? That life is worth living? I guess I gotta get out there and find out for myself. Goodbye, Rosa Blackwell. I don't know how long I've got, but I know I'll see you again. Someday. But until then, I'll try to make this count. Okay? Okay.
That was a perfect end. Wow. Beautiful. It's over. It's over. I'm just taking that in. There it is. That's the last Blackwell game. All the different character art from the different games. See how it progressed. Yeah, I'm gonna have to process it. I'm still trying to take it in emotionally. Alright, I'm gonna split my thoughts of this game off into a separate video. So, for now, I will leave you to watch the end credits and listen to this great music. And I just want to say thank you for joining me, thank you for watching. It's been quite a ride, this game. And it's over. It's over.
The time.